After getting married, we didn't waste any time before the adventures began. We saw a tarantula, we kayaked out to a private beach, and saw our first sea turtle. That kayak out to a private beach got us thinking, what other sort of secluded beaches are there on this place? After all of our adventures, the best part was coming home to one of the best views on the island. We couldn't help but put the full tour on the video. After getting accustomed to driving on the other side of the road, day two was a visit to the national park and a visit with our snuba instructor Frank for some underwater snubaing. All the booked adventures were cool, but we really wanted to venture out on our own. We had to go exploring a little, and thinking about a private beach was still on our minds. Little did we know what we would find.
me about what we just found at the beach.
I didn't know if I passed away and landed on what I pictured God placing me in heaven on this rock beach. It's beautiful. These rocks are perfectly smooth. I couldn't have asked for a better beach on a honeymoon with my love. Oh my goodness. Gotta skip these.
Got a little The Price is Right. So we went into Dolphin Market and we said we don't care what anything costs, we're just gonna buy it because it's our honeymoon. We also packed a cooler over there, which we were realizing paid off big time. So highly recommend for our future trips. Okay, Obs, what do you think this carton of eggs costs?
$4.
$3.45 for a carton of eggs.
That was pretty close.
That was good. How about this Caesar, of which we've used now a couple times?
Caesar dressing for our salads, $5.50.
Whoa, $5.45. Nice. Way to go. Good stuff. Okay, a pineapple. This we cut two of them.
The first one was better than the second one.
Yeah. What was the price of those?
I think I remember it actually.
Okay.
$6.
$6.95.
Almost
$7 for a pineapple.
Whole pineapple.
It was worth it. At least that first one was.
Yeah, the first one definitely.
Yeah. Wheat thins. A personal favorite.
They're almost gone.
Yeah, I ate them a lot.
I'm gonna say $5 for wheat thins.
Nice. This one was probably my most surprising. For this little box of wheat thins, of which might be a single serve in of itself for me at least. $6.45.
$6.45?
Yeah.
That's almost as much as the pineapple.
Bread. Full loaf of deli rye.
Yeah, rye bread because they didn't have anything else.
Yeah, I don't have a lot of selection there.
a loaf of bread, I'm gonna say, is about as much as the eggs.
$3.50. $4.45 for the loaf of bread. Last. And our absolute favorite.
We had to get ice cream.
Which has been worth every penny. But how much do you think?
So I'm gonna say this thing is $7.80.
Close. $10.
This thing of ice cream is $10?
Yeah. I know. But like I said, worth every penny. Day number 3 on St. John. About to get a dinghy here, pick up the dinghy here, and we have all these little bays, beaches to explore. We'll see what we make it to.
Okay.
And we're gonna go snorkel over there. But first, it's like an hour dinghy ride. We went to the only bay that's reachable by boat, so you can see it joined by some other boaters.
Ready for an adventure?
Bay, our untouched snorkel spot right there. We just passed a turtle on the way here, so we're very hopeful that maybe this will be the time to catch a nice sea turtle.
Here's the adventure for today. We are hiking pretty much across the whole island.
We're looking for a private snorkel beach spot today.
Okay, here we go. Yep, got the sunscreen for you tourist tree.
According to our calculations and our expert wilderness findings, we think this is the right trail.
Also, there's a sign right there that
there's
says Rape Bale Trail.
There's a sign.
We're gonna go in. We've found the ancient monument. Christmas orchids sometimes bloom on the rocky cliffs. Christmas Graham, that sounds fun.
There's Obs.
I hope so. Reef Bay Sugar Mill. Oh, look at that, like stove thing. Look at that. Look at that giant beehive way back there in the corner. That is the biggest beehive I've ever seen in my life.
Found the ruins. The trail has ended. We're about to find the private reef bay. It's our own little beach. There it is.
This was the most secluded beach we had found. We took some nice pictures, we swam with this one fish that we found, we jumped for joy on the beach, and we almost lost our flippers.
We also soon found out that the beach was infested with flies, and after getting in the water, it was hard to stay too long. So back we were, looking for our own beach once again.
Also, I just found a gem of a beach, all over, great snorkeling, sweet coral reef. We're like, all right, let's hike to north, all over bay, and then we're gonna sit here, eat lunch, be in the shade, and we came to this. Little mountains of seaweed here, and we renamed the beach
Yucky Beach.
Yucky Beach. There's a little bit of smell here.
Yeah.
And we watch as all the tourists walk through, they get a good sight, get a good whiff, and then turn around. So we're loving it.
Hallover was a great find, but there was one more place we thought we needed to check out.
We're on our way to a secluded beach that Frank Snooba Man told us about. We got the insider scoop. And this is the road we came on. There's our car up there. And now we have to hike a little ways to get to the beach.
It's a little crazy, I don't know.
We're a little bit skeptical, but Frank said, if you can get there, it's gonna be the best.
Snorkel scuba stuff in, and I said, Frank, you're local, tell me, what's the best bay, what's the best beach here, where should I go, where should I take my beautiful bride? And he said, he looked at me in the face all serious and he said, can you keep a secret? And I said, yes sir. And he's like, there's a hidden place called if you can find it, it's well worth it. Here
is
we
it?
Are.
Is it worth it?
It is worth it. It was worth every little hike of it.
Look at this place. It's incredible.
It's worth every little ding of the rental car.
Virgin Islands.